Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, how are you today? Before we continue watching this video, let's recite basmalah together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, we are from the seventh group. We will present English literature in the reign of Queen Victoria, or known as Victorian literature. Here is the members of seventh group. The first one is Wasti, and the second one is Mohanifun Nafis, and the third one is Yesi Maisari. Actually, in our group, there are four people. The three of us plus Rina Roseda Turoji. But this semester, Rina took time off, so she was not included in our group. Okay, let's start the material. Okay, first we will explain about the Victorian period. The Victorian era of British history was the period of Queen Victoria's reign from 1837 until her death in 1901. It was a long period of peace, prosperity, refined culture, great advancement in technology, and national self-confidence for Britain. During the Victorian age, Britain was the world's most powerful nation. By the end of Victorian's reign, the British Empire extended over about one-fifth of the Earth's surface. Like Elizabethan England, Victorian England saw great expansion of wealth, power, and culture. But as Victorian England was a time of great ambition and grandeur, it was also a time of misery, squalor, and urban ugliness. Jadi, begitulah sedikit gambaran tentang kondisi di era Victoria, yang mana nantinya akan berpengaruh terhadap literature pada masa itu. Okay, here is the picture of Queen Victoria. This photograph is created by Alexander Bassano in 1882. And Victoria, or Alexandria Victoria, was Queen of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland from 20 June 1837 until her death on 22 January 1901. Known as the Victorian era, her reign of 63 years and 7 months were longer than of any of her predecessor until 9 September 2015, who was later succeeded by his great-grandson Queen Elizabeth II as the longest ruler of Great Britain. And yes, Queen Elizabeth II is the queen who rules Great Britain today. Queen Victoria inherited the throne at 18 after her father's three elder brothers died without surviving legitimate issue. Though a constitutional monarch, privately, Victoria attempted to influence government policy and ministerial appointment. Publicly, she became a national icon who was identified with strict standard of personal morality. The social and cultural background of the period has had a deep impact on literature of the Victorian period. As I said in the previous slide, like that, some works of literature protested the grim reality of the industrial age, depicting the deplorable condition in factories and mines, the plight of child labor, the discrimination against women, and other social issues. Such literary works were meant as social reform. Elizabeth Gaskell's Mary Burton was one of the first novels warned against the problems of industrialization. Charles Dickens' works Oliver Twist and Hard Times treat the themes of child abuse, poverty, urban squalor, crime, and curb educational system. So, jadi seperti inilah sastra pada zaman Victoria yang dipengaruhi oleh kondisi sosial saat itu.
Okay, next I will be explain the material from our group, the material about characteristic of Victorian age literature. The characteristic of Victorian age literature among them. The first, literature tends to closer to daily life. The second, moral purposes. The third, idealism. Because that age of doubt and pessimism, and the last, great ideas like truth, justice, love, brotherhood, are emphasized by poets, essayists, and novelists of the age. So that's the characteristic of Victorian age literature. And next, literacy, publication, and reading. By the end of the century, literacy was almost universal. Compulsory national education required to the age of 10. Due to technological advances and explosion of things to read, including newspapers, periodicals, and books. Growth of the periodical, novel, and short fiction were published in serial forms, and the last, the reading public explicit literature to illuminate social problems. Next, about the Victorian's novel. The novel was the dominant genre in the Victorian periods. The first, Charles Dickens in 1812 to 1870. He created a host of unforgettable characters in such novels as Oliver Twist, Great Expectations, David Copperfield, Hard Times, and A Tale of Two Cities. And next is William Thackeray's. In 1816 to 1855, he created Jane Eyre. And next, Emily Brontë in 1818 to 1848. He's created Wood Herring Haig, a classic of English literature. And then is George Eliot's in 1800 1819 to 1880. Most important work are Middlemarch, The Mill on the Floss, and Adam Bede. And the last, the major novelist of the latter part of the period was Thomas Hardy in 1840 to 1928. Whose best work include Tales of the Tour Belfiles, Far from the Madding Crowd, and Youth the Obscure. Next, about the Victorian's novel, the early dealing with social and humanitarian themes, realist criticism of social evil, but faith in progress, general optimism. The main representative was Charles Dickens, and next the middle, showing romantic and gothic elements and a psychological interest. The main representative writers were the Brown sisters and Robert Louis Stevenson. And the late naturalistic novel near to European naturalism, showing a scientific look at human life, objectivity of observation, desertification with Victorian values. And then the main representative writers were Thomas Hardy and Oscar Wilde. And the last, this is the example of the Victorian novel, so you can see in the picture.
And then Victorian poetry, many characteristics of romantic poetry continued in poetry of the Victorian period. The first is, Victorian poetry in general is less subjective than the romantic. Terus selanjutnya, minat di masa lalu, baik klasik maupun abad pertengahan, muncul di subjek dan dalam penggunaan kiasan metodologis dan historis. Kemudian monolog dramatis banyak digunakan oleh para penyair. Kemudian temanya lebih realistis, membahas masalah-masalah seperti pekerja anak, hak perempuan, dan ilmu pengetahuan dan agama. Kemudian puisi Victory kebanyakan bergambar saat mengandalkan citra visual. Kemudian elegi adalah salah satu bentuk puisi yang paling populer pada periode tersebut, suatu bentuk puisi yang meratapi orang mati atau masa lalu. Kemudian the last is, Victorian poetry is often characterized by doubt and psychological conflict. Okay, for the next is the greatest poets of the period, yaitu Alfred Lord Tennyson dan Robert Browning. Penting lainnya penyair adalah yaitu Matthews Arnold, Gerard Manley Hopkins, Christina Rossetti, Elizabeth Barrett, Browning, Thomas Hardy dianggap penyair terbaik di Victory akhir. Jadi ini penyair-penyair terhebat pada periode itu. Romantic poetry versus Victorian poetry. Yang pertama yaitu puisi romantis diproduksi selama pemerintahan Ratu Victory, sedangkan Victorian poetry diproduksi selama perkiraan periode dari hingga 1850. Kemudian puisi romantis menggunakan tema seperti alam, kehidupan, pastoral, abad, pertengahan, Helenisme, dan supernaturalisme. And then picture and poetry menggunakan mitos abad pertengahan dan legenda serta masalah realistis seperti perjuangan antara sains dan agama. Kemudian, puisi romantis dipuji dan dikagumi alam, sedangkan puisi picturing lebih memperlakukan alam tampilan realistis dan kurang ideal. Kemudian, puisi romantis memberi keunggulan emosi, imajinasi, dan spontanitas, sedangkan puisi picturing lebih mementingkan intelek dan realisme. Jadi, ini romantic poetry versus picturing poetry. Kemudian, the fiction and drama. Sepanjang abad ke-19, drama melanjutkan penurunannya sejak periode restorasi. Paling, karya-karya pada masa itu kurang dan orsinalitas. Dua penulis drama adalah pengecualian untuk tren ini, Oscar Wilde dari 1856 hingga 1900 dan George Bernard Shaw dari 1856 hingga 1950. Komedi Oscar Wilde seperti The Importance of Being Earnest and Lady Windermere's Fun berlimpah secara lisan, polesan, dan sinisme. Drama Shaw membahas sosial semacam itu, pertanyaan sebagai pendidikan, perkawinan, dan sistem kelas dalam vena komik. Karya-karyanya antara lain Man dan Superman, Pygmalion, dan Sethe. So ini itu para pencipta fiction drama. Yang pertama Oscar Wilde dari 1856 sampai 1900, dan yang kedua yaitu George Bernard Shaw dari 1856 hingga 1950. Okay, that's all our presentation today. Jika ada yang ingin ditanyakan, bisa ditanyakan melalui forum diskusi di WA group. Saya ucapkan terima kasih buat teman-teman atas partisipasi dan telah menonton materi kami. Kami ucapkan terima kasih. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.